In this video, we will explain the sulci and gyri of superolateral surface of the cerebrum, right? So, as I have already discussed in my previous video, we have two main sulci here. One is the central sulcus, another one is the lateral sulcus, right? Central sulcus is the main landmark between the sensory and motor areas, right? In front of the central sulcus, we have precentral sulcus and postcentral sulcus, right? In between the central and precentral sulcus, we have precentral gyri. In between the central and postcentral sulcus, we have postcentral gyri, right? So, while discussing the frontal lobe, we have two sulci main, superior and inferior frontal sulci, which divides the whole of the frontal lobe into superior frontal gyrus, middle frontal gyrus and inferior frontal gyrus, right? Frontal lobe is finished. Now, come to the parietal lobe. We have interparietal, this one is the interparietal sulcus, this one is the interparietal sulcus, which divides it into superior and inferior parietal gyri, right? Let's come into the temporal lobe. We have superior and inferior temporal gyrus. This one is the superior temporal gyrus, this one is the inferior temporal gyrus. So, superior and inferior temporal gyrus, they divide the temporal lobe into superior, middle and inferior temporal gyrus, right? Superior temporal sulci, inferior temporal sulcus divides the into temporal lobe into superior, middle and inferior temporal gyri, right? We have superior, middle and inferior temporal gyri, we have superior, middle and inferior frontal gyri, but superior and inferior parietal gyri divided by interparietal sulcus, right? Now the main sulcus is the lateral sulcus. As I have already discussed anteriorly, this was the anterior pole, this is anteriorly, it has three projections, right? This one is the anterior horizontal, this one is the anterior ascending, right? Anterior horizontal, anterior ascending, then we have the posterior ramus, which itself continues as the stem of lateral sulcus. So these two are the anterior horizontal, this is anterior ascending, right? So we have three areas here. This one is called pars orbitalis, in between this is ascending anterior horizontal rami of the lateral sulcus. This is the anterior ascending. Ye wala part is called pars orbicularis. This one called pars triangularis. And this part is called pars opercularis. Right? Now, if we trace this posterior part of the lateral sulcus, we have the gyri surrounding the posterior stem. This is called the angular gyrus. Right? Supramarginal, sorry. The part that surrounds the posterior ramus of the lateral sulcus, that is called the supramarginal gyrus, right? That part which surrounds the, which cuts the, this part, superior temporal sulcus, the part surrounding the superior temporal sulcus, this one is called the angular gyrus. Jo lateral sulcus ke stem ko kara hai, that is supramarginal. Jo superior temporal gyrus ko kara hai, that is supramarginal. And this one is called, jo inferior temporal sulci ke upar ka gyrus hai, that is called the arcus temporo occipitalis, right? Lateral stem ke posterior side ke upar gyrus is called supramarginal gyrus. Superior temporal gyrus ke upar wale ko kehte hain hum angular gyrus. Inferior temporal sulci ke upar wale gyrus ko hum kya kehte hain? Temporo occipitalis, arcus temporo occipitalis, right? Now come to the occipital lobe. We have left with the occipital lobe. So, occipital lobe has first the lateral sulcus. This one is occipital lobe, right? So, occipital lobe has a lateral sulci. I will show you. This one is the lateral sulci. That will divide it to superior and inferior occipital gyrus, right? This is called the lateral occipital sulcus, right? Then when we have C-shaped sulcus, this is called the lunate sulcus, right? This is the lunate sulcus. Near the occipital preoccipital notch or near the occipital pole, we have lunate, right? Lunate sulcus. Then we have transverse sulcus, which runs, this one is the transverse sulcus. Jo parieto occipital sulcus ke thoda sa niche, 1 cm below the parieto occipital sulcus, there runs a sulcus which is called transverse sulcus. Thank you very much.